What is up, guys? Welcome to Automovie channel. It is, doubtlessly, one of the most abnormal variations of a high-volume vehicle on special in the US at the present time, the 2018 Chevy Equinox fitted with the organization's 1.6-liter EcoTec TurboDiesel. The truth is out, a standout amongst the most ordinarily American stages fitted with a motor kind that, particularly given the Volkswagen Group's current challenges, has never been more than a specialty player on these shores. Covered in outrage and old biases, it's difficult to envision numerous Equinox purchasers checking the costly choice box to fit the oil burner to their hybrid. At any rate, on paper. That is the reason we spent 7 days in one, schlepping all around town and with a lot of turnpike time, to make sense of if this thing bodes well given the deck apparently stacked against it. That is not an assertion of hostile to diesel inclination, it's only a rude awakening given the headwinds this kind of motor faces in the US, and really, even in Europe lately. Diesel has a ton taking the plunge, regardless of whether the relative splendor of the TDI was a wiped-out joke to everybody's detriment. Diesel motors give torque and brilliant economy, to the detriment of conceivably higher fuel costs and a powertrain that is more costly to deliver. The thrift's likely the greatest advantage to an Equinox purchaser, in light of the fact that there's no expanded towing ability, it's appraised at just 1,500 pounds. Contrasted with 3,500 on the off chance that you appropriately outfit an Equinox with a 2.0-liter turbo running on gas. Nor is it the least expensive Equinox, contrasted and alike prepared gas Equinox LT, it's a sizable $1,345 more. The Equinox diesel's 32 miles for every gallon consolidated on the EPA test cycle beats the 1.5-liter turbo gas motor by 4 miles per gallon, and given this present reality dissatisfaction inalienable in little gas turbo motor efficiency, it's most likely a greater preferred standpoint out in nature. The uniqueness is substantially bigger with the discretionary 2.0-liter gas turbo I4. To underline this more, the EPA appraises the yearly running expenses of the two vehicles to be about the same. This expect diesel costs about 40 cents more per gallon than normal gas, 55% of your driving is in unpredictable rush hour gridlock, and that gas turbo motors get someplace near their EPA rating out and about. Once more, this focuses to the diesel having leeway, however maybe not for an upcharge that is proportional to a year of fuel. Where the diesel sparkles is on the interstate. The front drive diesel is evaluated at 39 miles per gallon on the roadway, versus 32 miles per gallon for the littler gas motor. Our AWD prepared analyzer gets a 1 mile per gallon ding on the EPA thruway test and accomplished around 32 miles per gallon demonstrated throughout the week we had it, which included no less than 60% city driving. On level areas with the voyage set, the turbodiesel will return substantially more like 40 miles per gallon showed. In the event that you have a long turnpike drive or plan to take a considerable measure of street trips, there's a case for the turbodiesel over the 1.5-liter Equinox. This is a considerable measure of preface before getting to how it drives, obviously, however it's vital to set the stage. The Equinox itself isn't entirely different than the 2.0T prepared hybrid we drove recently, so we'll concentrate on the viewpoints that are dissimilar or particularly eminent. That addresses the Equinox's stage, which is identified with the cruise. Also, whatever you think about the cruise, it was intended for Europe from the get-go. So there's some heated and goodness inside this versatile stage, and by one means or another, in a section that is more about common sense and cost than driving flow, the Equinox has some genuine allure. What it needs more than anything is an inside makeover, not this is a defect interesting to the turbodiesel variation. its customer review by method for Fisher-Price. Sadly, we are of a firm assessment that you can do beguiling yet cheap insides. However, GM hasn't made sense of this yet. Gratefully, the major touchpoints are sufficient. The guiding wheel is flawlessly estimated and put, the front seats, canvassed in an interesting texture that seems as though it'll peel seriously, are really steady on lengthy drives, and everything else is sensibly masterminded. In any case, so it is with each other Equinox. The genuine inquiry is, should a purchaser fork over the $1,345 more for a boisterous diesel with an insignificant tow rating? On the off chance that there's a considerable measure of road in your Equinox's future, or on the off chance that you savor utilizing the slightest fuel conceivable to movement a silly separation between refueling, that is a yes. The Equinox's TurboDiesel reliably surpasses its EPA desires, something that no turbo gas motor can do. It's likewise extremely the main diversion nearby, unless the Mazda CX-5 with the SkyActiv-D TurboDiesel motor ever escapes administrative damnation. The main other diesel SUVs around are a stage up in both size and class. For us, having something moderately interesting covered up inside a good-looking however uninspiring structure is somewhat of an excite. The way that it's a fuel misanthrope yet in addition an agreeable, and by one means or another, pleasant, runabout takes it over the best. You'd must be slightly flighty to possess an Equinox TurboDiesel. In the event that strikes you as a compliment as opposed to a poke, this hybrid may be for you.